built a keyboard, but not just any keyboard. Pleased to present MouseKey. It's a split wireless keyboard where the right side functions as a mouse when the caps lock key is held down. It also supports scrolling in all four directions, zooming in and out, switching between desktops, and a few other shortcuts. You see, I spend a lot of time on my laptop. I'm still young, but crouching in that terrible posture all day will easily turn me into an old lady with back problems. There are two solutions. I could either get a monitor or a keyboard. On a laptop, I can use my thumb on the trackpad while keeping all my fingers on the keyboard. This maximizes efficiency and wastes no time between moving the mouse and typing. Anyway, I saw this on the internet and was inspired. But there were a few other things I personally would like different about Key Mouse. First, the colors. Black's just too boring, okay? The handrest looks comfortable, but then there are fewer keys available, the ortholinear layout, the confusing layers, and the retraining of muscle memory for certain keys and mouse click buttons. And there's no way to do the trackpad motions I'm so familiar with. I'll admit, ergonomic design is just too hard to CAD, okay? It'll become impossible to finish if I take on too big of a challenge. That's why I mostly stick with stuff I already know. What I know is Arduino. My plan was to use three Arduino microcontrollers that communicate with each other using radio modules. For the mouse on the right side, I used the mouse on my right hand, so I only need it on one side. I couldn't find an Arduino-compatible sensor, and it just seems too difficult to try to figure out how to capture the signal from the circuit board of a typical mouse and make it work with Arduino. So I ended up just buying a wireless USB mouse and expanding the computer adapter for two USB plugs. I simply connected a fat relay module to turn on the wireless mouse whenever the bottom left key is being pressed. Since this is a split wireless keyboard, each side must be battery powered. I wanted something rechargeable, but also don't really understand battery circuits much, so I opted for the smallest portable phone chargers I could find on Amazon. This 2-pack sold by Milady is still on the chunky side, but I like how it charges immediately without having to push a button. Unlike my cute Neko Hako, shame on you! The first thing I did was open a Google Sheets and plan the layout of all the keys I wanted. 3 months ago, I built my first keyboard just by following Feder Sosnin's instructions exactly. I even purchased a set of cute Shiba Inu keycaps. But of course, many keys stopped working after a few days because the soldering inside was just too weak, and I worried opening it up would end up ruining the whole thing. I'm reusing the keycaps, so I have to design my new keyboard to use existing sizes. Can I use the caps lock keys for mouse activation and the surplus of shift keys for the spacebar? Then I matched each key to a number, a global code name for the radio transmitters and receivers. The circuit works by reading the strength of the current that returns through the length of the resistors. Pressing a key creates a shortcut, a path that skips the strips of other resistors, allowing the current to return stronger with each fewer resistor gone. The obvious drawback is that when there are multiple keys being pressed, the electricity will take the shorter path, resulting in only the closest key that gets pressed sadly. Since there are a total of 9 ports on the Arduino Micro that are able to read this analog signal, we can only have 9 series of keys, and we want to reserve some of these series as private for the keys that are most often being used with other keys, such as Control, Shift, Command, and Option. Windows and Alt buttons for a PC. Fortunately, it's most unlikely for keys that are used by the same finger to be pressed at the same time, so we can arrange the series as nice columns. Using an Arduino Uno, I carefully measured the approximate values that would be received by pressing each key, and used those in the if statements. The programming for the left and right sides of the keyboard is actually pretty simple, since all it does is detect and identify which key is being pressed, and then send the appropriate key code via radio. The adapter that connects to the computer receives these radio signals and uses the Arduino mouse and keyboard libraries to perform the corresponding actions. By the way, you can sideways scroll on a mouse by holding Shift. I found a Chrome extension that can do the same kind of pinch to zoom as on a trackpad, but works by vertically scrolling while holding Option or Alt. And it definitely took way too long to calibrate the scrolling and zoom features to work at a comfortable pace using the keys. At the same time, I was also working on the CAD for 3D printing. So I was printing my final design one night, and as I was about to lie down in bed, I suddenly had a thought. My original design kept the function key and also offered two additional special keys in place of the spacebar on the right side, since I normally hit the spacebar with my left thumb. These keys, which I called tab left and right, were supposed to make it easier to switch between neighboring tabs on a browser window. I was even thinking of additional layers that would be activated by holding Control, Shift, Option, or Command for controlling window size adjustment and tab position. I had this thought that maybe having these keys instead of a spacebar would be a bad idea, since I do still use the spacebar with my right thumb, for spotlight search, changing keyboard language, and opening the emoji menu. So at 2:15 a.m., I rushed to my Ender 3 and stopped the print. While editing the Google Sheets plan, I even realized that the backslash keycap I had wasn't even the right size. I'm really glad to have made the changes before it was too late. Eventually, all the 3D printed parts were ready, and all that's left was to solder and assemble. But boy, was I unprepared for the hell that was to come. In total, I soldered for almost 24 hours. 2 days in a row, I was soldering from 6 p.m. to 2 a.m. There were just so many connections, so many chances for wires to be soldered on poorly, and despite how thick I designed the bases, there just never seemed to be enough room for all the circuitry to fit. Shoving caused more connections to be disrupted, and I ended up cracking open, fixing, and resealing the right side at least 10 times. After just 2 times, those screw holes at the bottom were unfortunately rendered useless. Everything should work now, but even if mouse key breaks someday, its cheerful outer appearance is still amazing. I had the most fun plugging in all the keycaps. With mouse key finished, I could do all the testing I wanted. Played some Type Racer, made digital art with cute cow stickies, even tried modeling in Blender. It actually works great! I even added the fuzzy side of Velcro dots to help with sliding on the bottom. MouseKey has the looks and functionality, but practicality, well, the keyboard is simply too tall to be comfortable. Even though P, space, and a few other keys are disabled while mouse mode is on to allow grabbing onto the keyboard for support, it still gets a bit difficult to drag the right side around without my arm and hand cramping up. Yeah, it wasn't cheap, nor was it fast to make, but for the fun factor, I don't regret it. If you're up to the challenge, I've posted my CAD code and circuit diagram in the description. Thank you so much for watching!